snatch it back and hold it, baby, one more time.
A viewer pointed out that my episode on using MIDI foot controllers with AmpliTube 5 failed to mention one of the most common use cases, and that's controlling presets in AmpliTube. Let me correct that oversight right now. AmpliTube is hardwired to accept a program change message for switching presets. The data byte of the PC message determines which preset is selected. If I use the settings menu and go to the control tab and then the program change subtab, I am at the table for assigning presets to program change messages. If I scroll down, you can see I've already assigned my first 27 rows. You'll note that AmpliTube prefers to start counting at 1, so when a data byte of 0 comes in from my foot controller, it will select PC row 1. My foot controller labels start numbering at 0, so that always causes an off by 1 bit of cognitive dissonance for me, but your controller may start at 1. To assign a preset, you just click on a row of the table. A browser shows up that allows you to navigate your entire preset library. Mine will look different from yours, as I've done a lot of customization here, but just get to the preset you want. I'll go by manufacturer, select Fender, then the Bassman, and the final step is just off the screen. I'll click on Annoying Neighbor. It will show up in the table. When you have the presets you want to use, remember to click the OK button to save your changes. You can specify up to 127 presets, which, unless you are in a Grateful Dead cover band, should cover all the songs you might play in a given night. When you come back to this menu, if you've done it correctly, your modifications should be here. Your pedal board may send out more than just the program change message and a data byte. Mine sends out 3 commands. I'll click on my pedal for preset 0. The first command has a control message with 2 data bytes of 0. Then another control message with a data byte of 32 followed by 0. Finally, the expected PC message with a data byte of 0. My understanding is that some target programs can support more than 127 program change messages by using bank switching, and these 2 control messages tell the target program to use bank 0. Your controller may do something similar if it doesn't support more than 127 program change messages. When I click the button for preset 1, you can see the same 2 preliminary messages go out, followed by the PC message with the data byte of 1. That's it. Sorry I missed this in the first MIDI tutorial. Rock and peace.